Well, it's been over 3 years since I got behind this thing for its annual oiling, so here we go again. And that's half the fun of working on this work, and is moving all the stuff out of the way so I can squeeze in back here. The last time I worked on one of these maintenance videos, I was showing how to fix a broken drawbar connection and how to properly oil a Hammond A100. But while I was panning around the back of the organ, a few alert folks out there with an eye for details commented that my oil wick on the vibrato scanner oil cup was missing, hence the title, Case of the Missing Oil Wick. To be perfectly honest, I didn't even know it was missing until a few of you pointed it out. I mean, what the heck is an oil wick anyway? But many years ago, I do seem to remember finding this strange string-like material that was wrapped around a flywheel and just dangling. I had no idea what it was or where it went. This was before the internet, and the only info I had was the owner's manual, which mentioned nothing about it. I just kind of forgot about it, since the organ seemed to work fine without it. But thanks to the internet and a few helpful people out there, I got educated on oil wicks. So here we go. This oil cup, located by the vibrato scanner, is one of the three oiling points of this particular model, and serves two purposes. A thread or oil wick wraps around an oil-saturated felt pad, which feeds oil to various points inside the vibrato scanner. There's a lot of rotating parts in there, and they need oil in order to keep functioning properly. Another thread, as you see is missing here, wraps around the same felt pad and comes out here. It goes down and ties around a brass bearing on a motor shaft below. And this bearing then receives lubrication from this thread. The earlier oil-based Hammonds like this one contain wicking like this throughout the organ, wherever there are any moving parts, including the tone wheel generator. This missing oil wick is common with Hammond organs of this age and older, this one being manufactured in 1964. They either deteriorate with age or get entangled somehow, which with the nearby flywheel, as mine probably did. This organ has been moved and hauled all over the country and has been turned on its side to fit through doors and a few other things, so that may have contributed to the cause. The question is, do I need to fix it? I'm sure Lawrence Hammond designed it this way for a reason. I figured if he put it in, it must be important. So I thought I'd better look into it and get it fixed before I start having problems with the bearing. That's not a good thing. I've been told you can replace this thread with any cotton thread from a fabric store, or just put a drop of oil on the bearing whenever you you do your regular oiling. But lacking a challenge, I wondered if it's even remotely possible to find something as obscure as Hammond oil wick cotton thread somewhere. I checked a couple of the parts websites, couldn't find anything, and I thought I'd check eBay where you can find almost anything. And like magic, there it was. Genuine oil wick cotton thread for the Hammond organ, $5 plus shipping. Well, I searched for it and I found it, so I bought it. Well, it came in the mail the other day. Doesn't look much like the picture, does it? They give you 7 yards of the stuff, and I just need about a foot of it. Maybe use the rest for dental floss. So here again is the shaft bearing where it ties around. There's a little groove in the bearing where it fits into. You just tie the string into place and wrap it around the oil felt. And here's what it looks like finished. No longer a case of the missing oil wick. It's securely tied around the bearing below and wrapped around the felt along with the oil wick from the vibrato scanner. This oil felt just lifts out so you can wrap the threads around it. It's probably a good idea to add a few drops of oil to the wick thread after putting it in. So, was this an easy task? Let's just say I taught myself a few new cuss words. If you do decide to do this yourself, be aware you'll be working in a very tight space. And I'd recommend investing in some long tweezers, which I didn't have, as well as a lot of patience. Didn't have much of that either. It took several tries. The string broke a few times trying to tie it, but I finally got it, and hopefully I won't have to do this again for another 40 years. If your Hammond has these four tabs, you've got what is called Hammond Percussion. And it works something like this. Okay, with the B preset turned on and a few of these drawbars on this set of drawbars, that's the second set of drawbars, without the percussion,
Sounds like that with the percussion on. And then turn the third on.
I haven't used the percussion in years, mainly because it doesn't work. It just started fading away over time until finally you couldn't hear it anymore. I didn't know what was going on. One recommendation was to use a shock treatment called zapping. Yeah, something like that. The procedure is pretty involved and is described to be very risky and could possibly damage your organ. I would like to see somebody demonstrate zapping someday. The one suggestion I found, and it was the one that worked for me, and also was the simplest. Look on the left side of the preamplifier. You'll find this adjustment knob for the percussion cutoff control, where you can control the amount of percussion volume you want. Give that a couple of turns just to clean it up. Next to that are these three tubes. These are the percussion tubes. And I just simply removed these tubes and reseated them. I then fired up the organ and the percussion was back strong as ever. I couldn't believe it. Why can't everything be this simple? After 47 years of just sitting there, I guess they probably weren't making good contact anymore. It's a good idea on an organ this age to pull and reseat all the tubes. Just the simple procedure of reseating all the tubes can solve a lot of problems. A loose tube can also cause static and a thundering noise through the speakers. Spraying contact cleaner like dioxin on the tube pins can work wonders as well. But try the reseating method first. Sometimes that's all that's needed. On the other hand, it could be a bad tube. Over the years, I've only had to replace a few tubes myself. This organ may be approaching the half century mark, but it's still sounding pretty good to me. Speaking of tubes, remember when you could go to Radio Shack or even a grocery store back in the day and they had these tube testers, you see, and you could take in your radio, your TV, or Hammond organ tubes and test them out to see if they were still good? I remember doing just that, only as recently as the 1980s. That's pretty recent, for some of us anyway. I don't even know where you could find a tube tester these days. Do they still exist? But the good thing is, if you need new tubes, you can still buy them online. Well, I hope some of this video will be of help if you have any of these same problems. I gotta give special thanks to Bob Herman at BobMan107's channel for his Hammond repair videos. His videos showed me exactly what I was looking for with clear visuals and descriptions even I could understand. He always gives helpful advice and was always quick to answer any questions I had. So thanks again, Bob. Like Bob mentions in his videos, I'm not an organ tech either. I only work on my own Hammond using information I find online and in the owner's manual, and just asking around. I find a lot of knowledgeable folks on YouTube and they're always happy to help, and I always learn a few new things. So keep sharing your experience and knowledge for the rest of us who need it, like me. Let's keep these old Hammonds working. Yes, does your store or any other Radio Shack in the area have a tube tester?
A who tester?
A tube tester.
A tube tester?
Yeah, for checking old radio, TV tubes. Used to carry them a long time ago.
Oh, no, sir.
Okay. All right, thank you.
All right.
Yes, I was wondering, does your store or any other Radio Shack in the area have a tube tester?
A tester?
Yeah, a tube tester, yeah. Are they for tubes, or like radio tubes?
Tube?
Yeah, tube for radios, TVs, and...
No.
Thank you for calling the Shack in the train station. This is Gordy. How can I help you?
Yes, does your store or any other Radio Shack in the area carry have a tube tester?
Like, maybe for wire?
No, for checking tubes on radio TV tubes.
Oh, no, sir.
Okay, thank you then. No dice. Those were the good old days.